Good morning. See, in the previous session, we learnt about the data collection. Okay. What are the surveys to be conducted to collect the data? We have listed some of the surveys also. See, that surveys are the home intro survey, commercial vehicle survey, taxi survey, roadside vehicle intro survey, postcard questionnaire survey, registration number plate survey, public transport survey, and lastly, that is the tag on vehicle survey. In previous session, we learnt, we have discussed in detail about the home intro survey. In this session, we are going to discuss about the remaining surveys. Okay. The next survey is the commercial vehicle survey. See, the commercial vehicle surveys are conducted to obtain the information on journey made by the all commercial vehicles within the study area. As we know, what do you mean by the study area? For which region or for which place we are going to provide the transportation facilities? That area, that total area. Suppose if you take Mysore city, okay, that is the study area. That is the study area. Within this, what are the commercial vehicles operating? That we have to collect the data regarding the commercial vehicles which are operating within this study area. We have to collect the data. So the addresses of the vehicle operators are obtained and they are contacted. How to get the addresses of the owners? By contacting the RTO, that is the regional transport office. By getting the help of RTO, we can get the addresses of the vehicle operators. As we know, commercial vehicle means that may be light commercial vehicle or heavy commercial vehicle. Okay. Normally, commercial vehicles means that is the goods carrying vehicles. As we know, luggage carrying auto, irbodo, athwa, that may be the trucks, single axle trucks, dual axle trucks, athwa, multi axle trucks, which carry the loads. That are the commercial vehicles. We have to collect the addresses from the RTO, Regional Transport Office. From there, we are going to collect the addresses. We have to request them. We have to explain the purpose of collecting these addresses. Later, we will get the data, means addresses. Then we are going to contact the vehicle operators. Then means vehicle operators or vehicle owners or drivers, we will get the addresses. Then we are going to issue the standard questionnaire format, means the forms are issued to drivers with a request that they record particulars of all the trips they would make. Whatever the trips they are making in their day-to-day life, that all should be entered in that form. Standard questionnaire format will be there. In that, they are requested to fill the particular trips. Whatever the trips they are making in their systematic daily life, that should be filled in that questionnaire format. See, this is a typical questionnaire format for the commercial vehicle survey. As it shows, firm or owner. First, firm means it is a company or owner name should be entered here. Okay, firm means it will have some more number of vehicles, one or two or more number. As we know, this goods carrying vehicles, which carries the finished goods or raw materials. Okay, that owners will have more number of vehicles. So, we have to enter the firm number or owner name or operator name. Next, address of the firm or company. Next, person intrude, whom we are going to intrude, whether it is owner or manager or driver, that should be entered here. Next, telephone number, phone number should be entered. Next, visit. Whether it is the first person, second person, our visit, we have to enter that. Next, time, on what time we are interviewing, that time should be entered. On what day, means the date, that should be entered here. Interviewer's name, means enumerator's name, who is conducting the survey, his name also should be entered. Because if any ambiguities, if any clarification is required in future, at that time the interviewer can be contacted. So, interviewer's name should also be entered there. Next, if any comments is there, that should be entered here. And for which zone the vehicle belongs, the zone number should be written here. As we know, in the study area will be divided into number of zones. As we know, this is the study area. See, for Mysore, in previous session we have discussed, for Mysore city, the ring road will be taken as the cordon line, means boundary for the study area. See, this continuous line, this is the boundary line, that is called as the cordon line, external cordon line or just cordon line, that is the boundary line. See, this dotted line, which is the boundary of the zone, that is the screen line. We have to enter the zone, for which zone it belongs to, whether it may be belongs to zone number 1 or zone 2, 3, 4. There may be number or there may be name for the zones. For example, here I have taken the number for identifying the zones. Next, part 1 in the questionnaire format. Okay, sir, nature of business, what type of business that firm is having? Okay, that we have to collect the data. Total number of employees in the firm or company, that should be taken. Number of vehicle operating from the addresses, and also we have to collect the data whether there is a place, means premises for the parking. That also should be checked, whether the vehicle is heavy goods vehicle or light commercial vehicle, that data should also be collected. And their day of travel, where they, systematic travel will be there, systematic transportation will be there. Day of travel, where they transport the goods, that all data should be collected. Total number of trips made on day of travel, as we know goods vehicle, they will have 2 or 3 trips, more than that also. Next, types of number of vehicles introduced. See, the types of number of vehicles means that may be commercial vehicle, that may be car, that may be trucks. Okay, type of vehicle should be entered. Next, vehicle numbers, how many vehicle we have introduced, and the registration number, that also should be entered here. Next, see, this is the part 2 of the questionnaire format, which contains the vehicle trip information. We have to enter the vehicle type, whether it is car or trucks, we have to enter the vehicle type, whether it is single axle truck or dual axle, whether it is tandem axle, we have to enter that. Next, vehicle number, registration number should be entered. Next, trip number, what are the number of trips they are making, that should be entered here. Origin and destination address, starting point and end point, origin address and destination address should be entered. And also the time of trip, okay, starting time of the trip, origin, from origin when they are leaving, they have to enter the trip. At what time they left the origin and at what time they reached the destination, that time should be entered. Next, nature of business means what type of goods they are transporting, that all data should be entered here. Okay. Next, advantage of commercial vehicle survey. See, the commercial vehicles should be categorized with this survey for the purpose, means for providing scheduled time for different sectors to avoid traffic congestion. See, if you provide separate time, separate scheduled time for the movement of the commercial vehicles, we can avoid the congestion. See, we can provide the separate time for the commercial vehicle, that may be early morning and the late evening. See, at that time the vehicle movement will be less, if the commercial vehicles can be allowed, because the commercial vehicles will have loading unloading operations, so it requires more space and all. So it relieves the congestion during the peak hours, that commercial vehicles are not allowed in the central business district where the commercial activities takes place during the peak hours, means during the daytime. The entertainment of these commercial vehicles will be, as far as possible, it will be avoided. During late evening or early morning, the commercial vehicles will be operated. It doesn't cause the congestion if you choose the late evening or early time, which is suitable for loading unloading operation, which occupies the parking space. As you know, the commercial vehicles will be very big. It occupies more space. So we have to operate them in the late evening or early morning. Next, easily estimate the commercial vehicles of a specific area. By conducting this survey, we can easily estimate the what is the percentage of commercial vehicle in that specific zone or in the whole study area. Lastly, the percentage of commercial vehicle and non-commercial vehicle. We should have the idea of operating the commercial vehicle in the specific area. That will be very helpful for the design of payment. See, as we know, payment, I think you all know about the payment. Payment is a structure. Normal road in nodidire, the blacktop or cement concrete, white top erthe, that is the payment. See, payment is a structure which consists few layers of payment materials. As we know, the payment materials are the soil, aggregate and bitumen. See, as I told, it is a structure, means it has a some definite thickness. The purpose of this payment is to withstand the wheel load, to carry the traffic load. Okay, see, whatever the load coming, we will consider only the load of the commercial vehicle. See, to design the thickness of payment, we are going to consider only the commercial vehicle load. Okay, we are not going to consider our personalized vehicle, and we are going to consider only the commercial vehicle loads. Okay, because they carry heavy load. As we know, the for single axle truck, for single, see, this is the single axle truck. See, just I have written the axle. Normally we have seen in the road, trucks will have a wheels like this. Front, they will have a single wheel. Rear, they will have a two wheels on either side. See, this is the single axle. See, this is the See, this is the dual axle. If it is there, one another addition, that is called as a multi-axle or tandem axle. See, for single axle commercial vehicle, the legal axle load is the 10.2 tons. Okay, in our personalized vehicle we will carry less load. See, this trucks will carry heavy load, so we will consider only this commercial vehicles for the design, means for the design of pavement thickness, we will consider only the commercial vehicles. So it is very important to conduct the commercial vehicle survey. Next, disadvantage of commercial vehicles. See, it is a time consuming survey. See, it takes more time. As we know, we have to collect the address from RTO. We won't get the suddenly addresses of all the vehicle operators. It takes some time. So the data collection will take some more time to collect the data, and we have to provide the questionnaire format after getting the addresses. We have to reach, means we have to post the questionnaire format to the vehicle operators or owners. So it takes more time. Secondly, field classification becomes hard during the signal. It is very difficult to identify the commercial vehicles in the signal. As we know, in the junction there will be a signal. At that time, during the red signal, the vehicle will be stopped. It will be very difficult to identify the commercial vehicles and to distribute the questionnaire format. Okay, we have to distribute the questionnaire format at the signal to get the reply back. Lastly, sometimes people don't want to give personal information. Sometimes people won't give the personal information due to afraid for the police. They are afraid for the police. So, as I told, the legal axle load is the 10.2 tons. They may carry beyond that load. Okay, at that time, the police will apply the fine. Okay, and also in which route they are making the trip, that they don't like to share with us. Okay, next, taxi survey. See, taxi survey, that is the intermediate public transport survey. As we know, taxi means that is the auto or cabs. See, the large urban areas usually have a sizable amount of travel by taxis. If you take example Mysore or Bangalore, metropolitan cities, there they will have a more travel by taxis, that may be using auto rickshaw or cabs. As we know, today we have a Ola, Uber and other cabs. Okay, it has a sizable amount of travel by taxi in metropolitan cities. In such cases, a separate taxi survey is necessary. We have to conduct the taxi survey to provide the facilities, to provide the transportation facilities in future. We should have a data regarding the taxi survey. What are the facilities to be provided for this? Parking space all should be provided. So we have to collect the data of taxis also. See, the survey consists of issuing questionnaires or log sheets to the drivers and requesting them to complete the same. We have to issue the questionnaire format to the drivers or vehicle operators and requested them to fill it and back, means they have to post it back. So we are going to provide them prepaid envelopes to reply, means to post back for us. Okay. Next, roadside vehicle intrusion survey. Roadside intrusion survey. See, the roadside intrusion survey is one of the method of carrying out a screen line or cordon survey. See, this roadside intrusion survey will be carried on the screen line. Okay, on the screen line or on the cordon line. Okay. See, the roadside intrusion survey can be done either by directly intruding the drivers of the vehicles or next, roadside intrusion survey. See, the roadside intrusion survey is one of the method of carrying out screen line or cordon line survey. See, this roadside intrusion survey will be carried on the screen line or on the cordon line. See, the roadside intrusion survey can be done either by directly intruding the drivers of the vehicles at selected survey points or by issuing the prepaid cards containing the questionnaire to all or sample of the drivers. Okay. See, the roadside intrusion survey can be directly done by directly intruding by using the enumerators or by issuing the questionnaire format to the vehicle operators. We cannot provide questionnaire format to all the drivers. Only for the sample of the drivers, the questionnaire format will be provided and requested them to reply for that questionnaire format by through post. Next, procedure, how to conduct the roadside intrusion survey. See, the survey points are selected along the junctions of the cordon line or screen line. We have to select the junctions on the cordon line. We have selected Mysore city as the study area, and we have selected boundary for the Mysore area as the ring road, that is the cordon line for this study area, means for the Mysore. See, along this cordon line we can select any junction. We can select, for example, we can select the Columbia Asia junction, which caters the vehicle from all the direction. It caters the vehicle from all the directions. Okay, see, the cordon line may be, the cordons may be in the form of circular rings or radial lines or rectangular grids. Okay, this ring road, okay, this cordon line may be in the form of circular, or it may be in the form of radial lines, or it may be in the form of rectangular grid. Okay, before this ring road was constructed, this Banni Manpa road, whatever the Banni Manpa road is there, that was the ring road, that was the boundary for the Mysore city. Okay, which is radiating from the inside the city towards outside the city, which is radiating, that can be considered as the radial lines. Okay, next, for small towns where the population is less than 500, single cordon line at the periphery of the town should be sufficient, or it is adequate. See, for where the population is less, there we can consider only single external cordon line at the periphery. At the periphery means at the boundary of the city or urban. See, because the internal travel being light, there the internal travel, the travel pattern will be very less. Because the population is less, so travel pattern will also, means the traveling, the movement will also be less. The external cordon line survey in that case will give the proper origin and destination data, means starting and end point, origin destination data will be obtained. Next case, where the population range is 5000 to 7000, where the population is high, if you consider the metropolitan cities, for example, Bangalore, okay, where the population is more than 75,000, two cordon line is necessary, okay, two cordon lines are necessary. The external cordon line at the edge of the urban development, the external cordon line being at the edge of the urban development, this is the study area. At the edge of the urban development, and the internal cordon line, the limits of the central business district. See, as we know, in Bangalore we have a outer ring road and inner ring road. Outer ring road can be considered as the external cordon line, and we have a internal ring road also in Bangalore. Okay, we have a internal ring road that we can consider as a internal cordon line, within which the central business district will be there, within which the commercial activities will take place. This will also gives the actual travel pattern. See, the roadside interviews at the intersection of roads with these two cordon lines should be able to fairly assess the patterns of travel in such cities. Okay, it fairly assess the travel pattern in such cities. It will be very helpful to conduct the survey, which will give travel pattern. It is very easy to assess the travel pattern. Next, for dual carriageways or roads with very little traffic, the traffic in both the direction is dealt simultaneously. When the traffic is very less, we are going to conduct the survey in the both the direction. We are going to conduct the survey in both the directions. See, this is the divided carriageway. There is a median at the central. There is a median at the central. We have a separate carriageway to carry each direction. See, where the traffic is very less. Okay, on that street, on that road, we are going to conduct the survey on both the direction at a same time, simultaneously, when the traffic is very less. When the traffic is very high, we are going to survey only the one direction. Okay, we are going to assume the same will be there in the opposite direction. Due to heavy traffic, we cannot conduct the survey. We are going to assume, for example, if you take my trip, I came from home to college, that is the working purpose trip. Again, evening, I will go from college to home. Same thing will be there in the opposite direction. So, we will assume the same trips will be there, same travel pattern will be there in the opposite direction. So, we are going to assume same number of trips in the opposite direction. Next, it is impractical to stop and intro all the vehicles. We cannot stop and intro all the vehicles. See, it causes the inconvenient. See, convenient sampling methods to be adopted. Convenient sampling methods can be adopted. Random sampling. Okay, one after the other. See, I am interviewing the one vehicle. After that interview, okay, after interviewing that vehicle, I can stop the another vehicles, or I can select it every 10th vehicle. Okay, first vehicle I have interviewed, next 10th, 20th, 30th, like that I can take the sample. Next, one has to ensure that vehicles are stopped in the interview bay without obstructing flow of traffic and with prior indication of warning sign. Simply we cannot stop the vehicle. We have to put the warning sign board should be there. Why we are stopping that? All information should be given to public. See, before conducting this survey, we have to give wide publicity, that through the media, that may be through the visual media or print media or through FM. We are going to conduct like this survey and we are going to seek the cooperation of the public to undergo this survey, which will be used to provide the transportation facilities in future. So we are going to provide the information for the public through the media. So one has to ensure that the vehicles are stopped in the interview bay without obstructing the flow of traffic with prior indication of warning signs. To stop the vehicles, we have to use the warning signs. As we know, there will be a traffic cones that will be placed, and we have to bring the vehicle, means we have to call the vehicle to side. We have to bring the vehicle to the side of the road where we will conduct the interview. Lastly, the period and duration of the survey are very important, means it matters, that need careful prior thought. A 24-hour survey will not be normally needed. Okay, 16 to 18 hours or 12 to 16 hours is sufficient. From morning 6 to late night 10, it is sufficient. Or from morning 7 to evening 7, 12 hours, it is sufficient. And it should be carried for throughout the week, means for all the weekday, from Monday to Friday. Next, for complete and reliable data to be obtained by the survey, it is necessary to frame and design the questions with care. The enumerator must also be given adequate training before conducting the survey, because there should not be any ambiguity in recording the statements of the, in recording the answers of the public. So there should not be any ambiguity. So the trainers, means the enumerator, should be trained well before conducting the survey. See, this is the simple form of roadside vehicle intrusion survey. See, this is the typical questionnaire format for the roadside vehicle intrusion survey. See, it contains day, on which day we are conducting the survey, that should be entered here. Date should be entered. Site, which zone, at which location we are conducting the survey, that data should be entered. On which direction we are conducting the survey, from Mysore to Bangalore or from Bangalore to Mysore, on which direction. Okay, on which direction we are collecting the data, that should be noted on here. Then vehicle type, what type of vehicle it is, whether it is two wheeler, four wheeler, car, bus, that all should be entered here. Number of occupants, if it is four wheeler, how many number of occupants are there? If it is bus, how many number of occupants are there? Okay, last stop, next stop, because there will be land use. Last stop, if you take public transport, okay, that will have some terminal station at the main junction, at the main points where the land will be used. Whether the land may be used for the residential or recreational or commercial or industrial. See, that should be entered here. Last stop, next stop, and land use. Last stop alli en land use agutte, that should be entered here. Next land use en bartade. Okay, next stop alli en land use bartade, that may be school or industries or office premises, that should be entered here. Lastly, the trip purpose. We are going to interview the public, means vehicle operator atho motorist interview martirthi. We can know the trip purpose, that should be entered here. What is the purpose of the trip? That should be entered here. The trip purpose should be entered. See, you can observe here, vehicle type. What are the types of vehicle we will come across on the road? That is here. Okay, that is the motor vehicle, car, taxi, city bus, light commercial vehicle, heavy commercial vehicle, that may be truck, passenger vehicles, that may be buses, country buses, like that. Land use. For what all the land is used, whether it may be used for residential or hotel, guest house, restaurant, school, colleges, university, similarly office, shops, markets, industrial or other utilities, hospitals, or cleanings, or for cultural purposes, that may be mall, theatres, lastly police station, military, fire stations. These are the examples for the land use. Next, trip purpose. The trip purpose may be for that, may be for to work, or from work to home, or from home to work, or for shopping, or for business, for school, or any for personal affairs. Okay, like this, our trip will be there. That may be the purposes. Next, advantages of roadside intrusion survey. What are the advantages of conducting this roadside intrusion survey when compared to other type of survey? See, roadside intrusion survey is an economic method of survey and it's accurate and reliable data. See, we are going to collect data personally. We are going to enter the data provided by the motorist or vehicle operator. So it will be very accurate and it can be reliable. We can depend upon that data. Well suited to condition where personnel are limited. In case of home intrusion survey, outside intrusion survey, we require more human resources. We require more personnel. We require more number of enumerators. But here the number of enumerators will be less when compared to home intrusion survey. So it takes less cost. Disadvantages of roadside intrusion survey. Firstly, stopping of drivers can create congestion and antagonize to the public. See, stopping can create the congestion and also it causes inconvenience to the public. Next, the intruders have no statutory powers to stop all the vehicles and question the drivers. See, the intruders doesn't have any statutory power to stop the vehicles. So they have to seek the help of the police. So we don't have any authority, means we are not the authority to stop the vehicle. So we have to seek the police help to stop the vehicles, to conduct the intrusion. We have to take the help of the police. Next, that is the only the information about vehicle trips is obtained. What the trips they are making, regarding that we will get the data. But in case of home intrusion survey, all the trips they make in their systematic daily life, that data will be obtained in case of home intrusion survey. But here we will get the information about the vehicle trips. Present trips data will be obtained. That is the disadvantages of this roadside vehicle intrusion survey. Next, postcard questionnaire survey. See, in this method, reply paid questionnaires are handed over to each of the drivers or a sample of them. We cannot provide to all the drivers. We are going to provide for sample. Means if there are 100 vehicles are operating in the road, means we cannot provide for all the 100. Okay, we are going to provide only for few, for the selected people. How we are going to select, that will be random. Randomly we are going to select and we are going to provide the questionnaire and we are going to request them to fill it and post it back. So how to post, we are going to provide the prepaid envelope covers, because the public or the drivers, they are not ready to pay and do post. So we are going to provide the prepaid envelopes to post it back. Okay, see, the method avoids delay. See, when compared to other method, it avoids the delay caused to the drivers by direct roadside intrusion method. See, in case of roadside intrusion method, we are going to stop the vehicle and we are going to intrude the driver or operator. That takes some time. This causes the delay for the driver or vehicle operator. So that will be overcome in this method. But this method suffer from the disadvantage that the response may not be good. Okay, in case of vehicle intrusion survey, we are going to conduct the survey, we are going to take the data and we are going to record all the information. But in this case, the vehicle operator going to enter the data, means they are going to record. Okay, they may reply or may not reply. So it suffers from the disadvantage that the response may not be good when compared to other methods, that are the home intrusion survey method or roadside vehicle intrusion survey. So for this reason, it is not used generally. Recommended for developing countries. In developed region where the educated and skilled person will be there, we may get the reply. But in developing countries and underdeveloped countries, we cannot expect the same. So next, as regards the selection of survey points and questions asked are very similar to the roadside intrusion survey technique. Whatever the questions asked in the other survey, same type of questionnaire formats, means same questions will be there in the questionnaire format. Next, a good amount of publicity is needed before the actual survey in order to get favorable responses. We have to give wide publicity, that through the media, that may be through the visual media or through the print media or through FM. We have to give the publicity as we are conducting this type of survey, we have to seek the cooperation of the public to undergo this survey to get the good response. Next, it is reported that well planned and publicized postcard questionnaire surveys have yielded returns of 50%. Okay, they yield result only 50%. In case of home intrusion survey or in case of roadside intrusion survey, it will be near to 90 to 100%, but here the result yielded will be only 50%, not up to the mark. Lastly, the postcard survey is designed to capture the origin, destination, purpose of the trip, frequency, and also what are the number of people in the vehicle, and also which route they are selecting. This all data will be collected through this survey. Next, advantages of postcard questionnaire survey. What are the advantages? See, when compared to other surveys, it saves time, because here we are not going to record any data, we are not going to stop the vehicle, it doesn't cause any delay to the enumerator or vehicle operator, it saves the time. Secondly, it is a low cost method. When compared to other methods, it is very low cost, but because it requires less enumerators, human resource will be required will be very less, and salary will be saved when compared to other methods. Next, the methods avoids delay caused to the drivers by the direct roadside interview method. In other method, that is the direct roadside interview method, there we are going to stop the vehicle and it causes delay for the driver, means for vehicle operator, that can be overcome by this method. Lastly, the method is simple and cheaper than any other method. This method is very cheaper and simple when compared to other method, that is the roadside vehicle interview survey irbodu athwa home interview survey method. When compared to other method, this method is very simple and easy to conduct, and it is also cheaper because we required less human resources, less enumerators are required, so it is cheap. So if home interview survey, there human resource required will be more, we have to pay more for the human resources, but here the human resource required will be very less, so it is cheaper. Next, disadvantages of this postcard questionnaire survey. See, the response is not good. Okay, the questionnaire format will be provided for the vehicle operator, means public, they may reply or not, so the response, we cannot expect the good response. See, the response is not good. Secondly, sometimes it makes delay to reach the destination. Sometimes they may forget to post. It takes more time to reach the destination. Even when they post it late, it takes some more time to reach the destination. Next, it is not possible to get good amount of information from this method. See, in other methods, we are going to enter the data, means we are going to record the data. Here, the public, means the vehicle operator, is going to enter, means they are going to record the data. They may provide, they may not provide, or they may biased. Okay, whatever the one vehicle operator may provide, same thing may be provided by his friend. Okay, the accuracy level is very less when compared to other methods because they may biased. Next, it is not possible to get good amount of information from this method. It may not possible because in other methods, we are going to collect the data, we are going to enter all the records, all the particulars will be entered by the enumerators, but that is not same in this case. So the accuracy level is less. Lastly, it contains doubt about the accuracy level. We may doubt the accuracy level. They may be biased. The public, means the vehicle operators, if their 2-3 friends are there, means they may be biased. Same answer may be provided by all the three. So the accuracy level cannot be up to the expected mark. Next, registration number survey. See, in this case, the registration number plate survey consists of noting the registration numbers of the vehicles entering or leaving an area. As we know, this is the study area. See, on the study area, at some point on the junction, we have to select the survey point. When the, see, this is the, these are the zones, the whole, this is the study area. When the vehicle enters this point, when the vehicle crosses this junction, we have to enter the registration number. When this vehicle exits from this area, from this zone, again we have to enter the vehicle registration number. This will give the idea from which area to, from which zone to which zone the vehicle is moving. Okay, you can take example, this is a zone number 1, this is zone number 2. We can get the idea whether the vehicle is moving to zone 1 or zone number 4. We can identify the travel pattern of the vehicle by conducting this survey. So for that, by matching the registration number of vehicles at the points of entry and exit from the area, one is enabled to identify the paths of the vehicles. One can identify the paths of the vehicle, means movement of the vehicle. Next, the method neither gives the origin or destination. In other methods, in roadside interview survey method or home interview survey method, we are going to get the origin and destination, means starting point, end point, but we are not getting the starting end point. Just we are only getting the travel pattern, from which zone to which zone the vehicle is operating, means from which zone to which zone the vehicle is moving. That idea we'll get. We won't get the exact starting or end point in this case. Okay, the area to be surveyed is defined. First, the area to be surveyed is to be defined. The road intersecting the cordon line are identified. As already I have written here, see, first we have to define the study area, then we have to fix the cordon line, then we have to select the survey point to conduct the survey. Next, at each survey point, one or two observers are stationed to record the data in each direction of travel. Okay, we have to make station of two observers. One is to call the registration number and another person is to record the registration number. Suppose if you take example in Bangalore, there we may require more number of observers because the number of vehicles will be more. Where the traffic is more, there we require more number of observers. Means to call out the registration number, simultaneously one has to record that number. Lastly, the time should be recorded. Okay, the time should be recorded when the vehicle has entered this zone. The time should be entered when the vehicle leaves this zone. When it crosses the screen lane, we have to enter the time. Means this will give the journey time. This, by using this, we can calculate the speed of the vehicle also. Lastly, the types of vehicles. The types of vehicle means what are the types of vehicle? That data should also be, because we are going to collect the, means we are going to record only the registration number plate. So it should match with the vehicle. So we are going to collect the types of vehicle also. What type of vehicle it is, whether it is car, bus, four wheeler or two wheeler, whether it is truck, that data should also be collected here. Next, manual method is organized by allotting data from each survey point to different person who sit around a table. See, after collecting the data, they will reach the office. There they will allot the sheets. Whatever the data collected sheets will be there, that will be allotted to the enumerators. Then they will match the number. Okay, the entry level in record agide, exact exit eno entry agide, that should match. Elli entry agide, elli exit agide, that should be matched. Okay, namatra entry agiranta registration number entry agiranta record irutade, that by keeping that record we have to match that from which zone to which zone the vehicle has moved. Yava zone in the yava zone ge vehicle movement ide, that can be matched by observing this vehicle registration numbers. Okay, see, the registration numbers of vehicles are called in turn. It will be called in turn. The persons having the survey data at exit point match them with their entries. They will match entry mathe exit. Okay, exit level. Okay, they will match that registration numbers. Next, when a number is thus matched, the passage of that vehicle in between the two points, now it is known for us. So it will be entered in a suitable form. Okay, from zone 1 to zone 2, it is moving. Okay, from this zone to this zone, that we can enter in a separate suitable form. Next, separate form will be there. In that we will enter. Lastly, if any number is not matched, the reason may be that the particular vehicle entered the survey area but did not move out during the survey time. Either it may be parked there itself, athwa whatever the number we have taken, whatever the number we have noted, that may itself be wrong. Now entry maadkondirade toppirbodu, wrong agirbodu. Okay, that may be the case if it is not matched. Next, advantage of registration number plate survey. Firstly, the work does not interfere with the traffic. In other case, that is the in case of roadside vehicle intrusive survey, it obstructs, it stops the traffic, means it causes inconvenience to the traffic. That is not exactly same with this case. Here we are not going to disturb the traffic. Next, secondly, it identifies the entry and exit points of traffic passing through the city. Okay, entry mathe exit point easily nam godagtide, from which area to which, from which zone to which zone the traffic is moving. Okay, from which zone to which zone the traffic is attracting, that will be easily known by conducting this survey. Next, the registration number survey can also provide journey time information for through traffic. We can get the journey time also. When the vehicle entered this zone, we are going to record the registration number. Same time we are going to record the time when it has entered. Similarly, when it has exit this zone, we are going to enter the time and registration number. So we are getting the journey time, travel time. We are going to get the travel time. Next, it is useful for checking movements using alternative routes, whether they are using the alternative routes or any other routes. That will be very useful to find out the alternative routes. Lastly, the drivers are not inconvenienced and there is a lower unit cost of observation when compared to other method. Here there will be no inconvenience for the road users, means for the vehicle operators, and it requires low unit cost. Okay, low unit cost when compared to per person. In other method there may be some inconvenience. Here there is no inconvenience for the vehicle operator. If you take example roadside vehicle intrusive survey, it causes some inconvenience, that may be delay agabodu vehicle operator ke. But here there is no inconvenience and it is also less, means it requires low unit cost of observation. Per observation it requires low unit cost. In others, okay, per observation it will be very costly in case of home intro survey and roadside vehicle intro survey. Per observation it will be very costly, but in case of this lower unit cost of observation, per observation it will be very, it requires low cost. Next, disadvantages of registration number plate survey. What are the disadvantages? See, a large number of observers are needed for this survey. See, as I told, if you take example Bangalore, see, in a signal we cannot count the number of vehicles only. How can we recognize the registration number plate? So we require more number of enumerators for each category, for two wheeler, for four wheeler, for trucks, for buses. For each category of vehicles we should have a separate observers to call the numbers and to record the data, means to record the registration number. So it requires more number of observers. Next, the journey information lacks the details of about OND, means that the origin destination. See, the data will be there, but that journey, it doesn't give the origin and destination, starting point and the end point. Okay, we doesn't get the idea about the origin and destination, starting point and the end point, the idea sigala in this case. See, the processing of the information and analysis of the results can be complicated. As I told, we have to sit in the office, we have to match the entry and exit of the registration number. It is very cumbersome, it causes some ambiguity, it causes difficulty, it is very difficult to match it. Lastly, the procedure of this method is very difficult, means it is very cumbersome to match the numbers, entry and exit numbers in match madlike, it is very difficult. The procedure of this method is totally difficult when compared to other methods. Public transport service. See, in order to assess the number of bus passengers passing through an external cordon line, the survey can either be by direct intro with the passengers or by issuing postcard questionnaires. See, here we can have two methods to conduct the survey, either by interviewing directly or by providing the standard set of questionnaire format to the passengers. Directly we can conduct the interview while moving, or at the terminal station we can conduct the interview of the passenger. What are the facilities need to be provided and what are the difficulties they are facing, that all data can be collected here. Next, an external cordon line railway survey can be done, means interview can be done in the railway station, and also during the movement, during travel also we can conduct the survey. Next, alternatively, prepaid questionnaires may be distributed to persons residing at station, nearby station air irtare, for them we are going to provide the prepaid questionnaires, means prepaid envelope questionnaire will be provided to the passenger. They are asked to reply for that, means they are asked to reply for that questionnaires, means how to answer and all, that may be provided through the media, that may be explained through the public media, means that may be through the visual media or print media. Through that we can explain how to fill these questionnaires and all, that can be explained through the media. Lastly, these questions may also be collected at the station, means during travelling. Next, advantage of public transport survey. See, interviewers get information by direct intro through this method. By conducting the direct intro, we can record all the data, so we can reliable on that data. Secondly, it helps to provide different types of mode which is needed to the public. So by collecting the data, we can overcome what are the problems that route athwa that public are facing in that region, that can be overcome by providing the facility to overcome that problems. We can use that data to provide the facilities. Secondly, it helps to provide different types of mode which is needed to the public. By collecting this data, we can improve the public transportation in that area. We can improve that. We can provide efficient public transportation to attract the public. Next, postcard questionnaires also eliminate delays. Okay, during traveling it may cause the inconvenience for passenger, or it may take some time. So by providing postcard questionnaires, it eliminates the delays. Lastly, it helps in transportation planning by public participation. In public transportation survey, there will be participation of the public. So it helps to provide efficient public transportation. Next, disadvantages of public transport survey. See, the direct interview is like to result in large delays. By conducting direct interview, it takes more time. It causes inconvenience for the passenger. Okay. Secondly, it requires large number of interviewers. It requires large number of enumerators or surveyors, means interviewers, to conduct the interview, means to record the data. It requires more number of enumerators, which is difficult to get. Next, postcard questionnaires contains the element of bias. Okay, they may be biased. Same results may be obtained for all the questionnaire format. Lastly, it is likely to evoke poor response. Okay, it may be if you provide the postcard questionnaire, okay, that may, we may not get the good response. As we have studied in the postcard questionnaire survey, the result will be up to 50%. Okay, so the response may not be good if you provide the postcard questionnaire survey. Next, tag on vehicle surveys. See, in this method, at each point where the road cross the cordon lane, vehicles are stopped and tag is affixed. Means the tags will be fixed, usually under a windscreen wiper. For the wiper, the tags will be fixed. Okay, the tags, when the vehicle enters the survey point, the tags will be fixed to the windscreen wiper. For wiper, the tags will be fixed. See, the tags for different survey station have different shapes and color. For uniqueness of for each zone, there will be different shape and color tag. See, next, the vehicles are stopped again at the exit points where the tags are removed. Okay, after exit, okay, after reaching some other zone, the tags will be removed. Okay, next, the times of entering and leaving while fixing the tag and while removing the tag, okay, the time will be entered. This will give the journey time, means travel time from one zone to another zone. Next, if it is not possible to handle all the vehicles, sampling may be adopted. We cannot fix the tags for all the vehicles. At that time, we can apply the samples. That may be random sample atwa simple sample method can be applied. Okay, for every 10th vehicle, 20th vehicle atwa for which vehicle we can fix the tags. For that vehicle, we will fix the tag. Like this, the sample can be adopted. Lastly, the parking areas are surveyed at the end of the study period, because the vehicle may have entered this area, but it has not passed from this area, means it has not moved out from this area. It may be within that area only, it may be parked. That data should also be collected, okay, by visiting the parking places. Lastly, the advantages of tag surveys. See, the analysis of this method is very simple. When compared to other method, the analysis is very simple, because we are going to fix the tags. Okay, for each zone, there will be a separate color and shape of tags will be there, and we can identify for which zone this tags belongs to. So it is very easy, means it is very easy to analysis. Next, the method can also be extended to cover vehicles that enter the area but are parked in the area during the rest of the study period. Okay, we are going to fix the tags when that vehicle not moved from that area. When it has not moved from that area, it will be in parked space, means it will be in the parking area. We can collect that tag also, and we can get the area. The vehicle is within that area only. Secondly, the method can also be extended to cover vehicles that enter the area but are parked. See, when the vehicle has entered this area and it has not moved out from this area, we can collect that data also by visiting the parking places. Lastly, that is the disadvantages of tag surveys. See, it is time consuming method, because we have to stop the vehicle and we have to collect the tags and we have to enter the time and all. Again, we have to segregate that, similar to registration number plate survey. We have to match that. Lastly, it is never possible to survey all the vehicles, means we cannot fix the tags for all the vehicles. So we may go for sampling method. That may be random sampling or simple sampling methods can be chosen. Okay, these are the types of survey to collect the data. That is the home intro survey, commercial vehicle survey, taxi survey, roadside intro survey, postcard questionnaire survey, registration number survey, public transport survey, and lastly, tax on vehicle survey. These are the surveys used to collect the data regarding the travel pattern between the zones, means within the study area. To get the travel pattern within the study area, we are going to conduct this surveys to collect the data. Okay, thank you. We will discuss the further topics in the next sessions. Thank you.